In this video, we're going to talk about defining functions that use nested structures, that is, structures that have other structures inside of them. This will be a very important topic as we continue on in this course. We're going to start with the point structure we've already seen so far in this lecture. Now we're going to write a simple function that takes a point and increases its y-coordinate. Let's start with the signature, purpose, and header. Now let's write some examples. In these examples, we see that the x-coordinate doesn't change, and the y-coordinate increases by 1. Here's the template for points. We see that we can access the two components of a point, point-y and point-x, and we use p, the point we're working with, as the input in both cases. One thing to emphasize here is the parallelism between the data definition and the template. The data definition has two numbers in it, right here, number and number. Our template also has two numbers in it. Point-y of p and point-x of p are both numbers. This parallelism between the data definition and the template is one of the important parts of making templates work for you in helping you define functions. Now let's finish the function by constructing the new point that we need. We need to reuse the x-coordinate unchanged, and we need to add 1 to the y-coordinate. Now we need to put the two coordinates together into a point with make point. Now we're done, and we can run our program. Now let's consider a new data definition, couple of points. Couple of points has three possibilities, just like the shape definition that we saw earlier had two possibilities. And each of these possibilities is a structure, just like in shapes. However, the big difference is couple of points references the point data definition. The inputs to make one and make two are themselves points, whereas the inputs to our shape constructors were numbers and strings. When we see references to other data definitions, as here with point, inside a data definition, we're going to follow that structure in our template and our functions when we use helper functions to solve the problems. Let's begin by writing some examples of couple of points. Here we have three examples of couple of points, each representing one of the three ways that we can construct couple of points, with make none, make one, and make two. As we see, we use make point to construct the points that are inputs to make one and make two. Now let's write down the template for couple of points. To do that, we're going to write down the skeleton of a function, process CP, that takes a couple of points and shows what the skeleton of that function will look like for any function that processes a couple of points. As we see, we wrote down part of a signature for process CP, but we don't know what it's going to produce because this isn't a full function. We're just writing down the template. Now let's think about what this template is going to look like. Couple of points has a one of in the data definition. Therefore, we're going to have a conditional in the template. There's three possibilities in the data definition. Therefore, there are going to be three clauses in the template. Each clause is about a different structure. So we can use the structure predicate functions, none question mark, one question mark, and two question mark to determine whether CP is a none, a one, or a two. Now we need to figure out what should go on the right-hand sides of our conditional clauses in our template. For the none case, there's no extra information that we have available in our template, so we're just going to leave dot, dot, dot as it is. For the one clause, there's one piece of data. It's a point. We access that point with one-first of CP. For the third clause, for the two structure, there are two pieces of data, both of which are points. But we're not done yet. Both of these are points, and point is a reference to a different data definition. That means that our template is going to reference the template for points in each of the places where we reference point in the data definition. So I'm going to write process point as a reference to the template for processing points around each of these points in our template. Here's the finished template for a couple of points. Let's put it next to the data definition. When we put it next to the data definition, we can see that they're very similar in structure. They each have three possibilities. Each possibility has a variety of pieces of data in it, 0 in the first case, 1 in the second case, and 2 in the third case. Those pieces of data are points in each case, and they're references to other data definitions, and therefore we have a reference to another template, the process point template. When you write down a template for processing a structure with other structures inside of it, it should follow all of these rules. Conditionals, the appropriate number of clauses, selector functions like one-first, and references to other templates when you have references to other data definitions. In case you didn't write down what process point is going to look like as part of your procedure for solving problems with the point data definition, here's what it'll look like. We have a process point, which takes an input p, and we see that point-x and point-y are available. Now that we've completed the template, let's work on movePointsUp, which is a function that processes a couple of points. It's going to use the movePointUp function that we've already written, and it's going to use that on all of the points in a couple of points. Here's the signature, purpose, and header. Takes in a couple of points and produces another couple of points. Now let's write some examples. Now we have three examples for movePointsUp. Now let's use our template to continue designing this function. I've copied in our template, and you can see that it's done a lot of the work for us. One thing that's important to note is that there's still references to process point inside this template. That means we need to figure out what helper function we're going to use to process the individual points inside movePointsUp. Fortunately, we've already written a function that moves a single point up. That function is movePointUp, and we can just use it in each place that we have process point. Our template told us exactly where these helper functions needed to go and exactly how many times we needed to use it. Now let's finish our function definition by using the make none, make one, and make two constructors to construct the appropriate couple of points in each case. If we start out with no points, we end up with no points. If we start out with 1 point, we end up with 1 point. If we start out with 2 points, we end up with 2 points. Now let's run our program and see that everything works. Now we're happy. We've finished our movePointsUp function, and we've seen how to work with nested structures.